I want to make a visual about the root mean squared voltage because we can do it in Python. I want to do this in Python. So imagine I have an AC source with an AC voltage and a resistor. So I can write the loop rule as V0 sine omega t equal, minus IR equals zero, right? Because there has to be the voltages have to add up to zero. So from this, I get I as a function of t equals V0 over R sine omega t. That has to be true. Now, if I calculate the power, which we could write as I0 sine omega t. If I calculate the power, it's I times V. So that's going to be equal to I0 sine omega t V0 sine omega t, or I0 V0 sine squared omega t. Now, if I want to calculate the average, that's going to be equal to I0 V0 1/2. The average of sine omega squared t, sine squared omega t, is 1/2. And that's what I want to show. I want to show that that we can calculate that numerically. So let's just plot. I want to plot two graphs. V0 is a function of time, and P is a function of time. And then we're going to talk about how we find the average of that numerically, okay? Without calculus. So I'm switching over here to Python, and I want to make this a little bit bigger. That looks pretty good. And let's make a graph. G1 is graph. This is going to be title equals voltage. I'll put voltage. X title, time in seconds. Y title, V in volts. And then I'm going to put width 500, height 200. I usually do 250, but because I want it to display next to another one, I did that. And then I'm going to make a graph. FV equals G curve, color equals color dot blue, and let's just plot this. Okay, so there's my voltage, my angular frequency, my time step, and I can say while t less than 5. I'm not sure about that, and I'm not gonna animate. I'm just gonna display it. I'm gonna calculate v. V equals v0 times sine omega times t. I'm gonna plot it. Fv dot plot t v. I need to increase t. And, you never know. Should I increase t first or after I plot it? It doesn't matter if your delta t is small enough. And let's run this. It should make a graph. That's pretty easy. Okay. Now, I'm going to plot the power. So I'm going to pick a value for the resistance. Let's say R equals 10. I don't really know. And I need to make another graph. G2 equals, I'm going to copy this stuff. Let's just copy this whole thing. Control C, paste. I'm going to call it G2. And this is power. And this is going to be P in watts. And let's make it red. And that's FP. And so I'm going to say let's go ahead and calculate I. I is going to be equal to V0 times sine omega times t divided by R. And then so the power is going to be I times V. And then I can plot that. FP dot plot. Now, just a quick note, if you put the order up here the way you want it, it will plot this one on that graph, this one on that graph. So that's what you want. FP dot plot TP. Let's see if it runs. Okay, that's what I wanted. You'll notice here that the average voltage over one cycle is zero, right? Because it's just as much positive volt as negative volt. Now down here, since I have the squared term in there, it's always positive. So I can find the average of this one. And I want to show you now that the average of sine squared omega t is 1/2 over one cycle. So I'm going to make a new, let's just plot sine squared. So I'm going to get rid of this, and I'm going to just call this sine. I'm going to call this sine. And I can get rid of this one. And I just want to plot sine omega t. So let's just call this f. F equals sine omega t. F equals sine omega t squared. That's my function. And I'm going to plot t, f. And then that's gone. That's all I'm going to do. I don't need to calculate that other stuff. Let's just see if it works. And it didn't, because I felt like I just can't find the variable v. Oh, that's right. I don't need to calculate this stuff. Okay, so there's my sine squared. So that really should be sine squared. Sine squared. Sine squared. It really could be f. Okay, now the next thing I want to do is I want to go over one period. So I want to go till t is t. So f is going to be equal to, and I'm just doing this in my head. That's why I'm doing it in a weird way. F, so omega is 2 pi f. So f is omega divided by 2 times pi. I know this is really backwards. And then the period is 1 over f. So I'm going to say this there. Let's see if that works. It should just do one period. That is one period. You may think that's two periods. No, that's one period, right? Because it's squared, right? This is the all the way down here and back up. That would be one. Okay, now how do I average that? How do I find the average? And the answer is I'm going to sum up all the voltage values, the sine values, and divide by the total time. Let me switch to the paper and I can show you what we're going to do. So this is not actually a function. It's a bunch of data points, right? So imagine that I have my function and it looks like this. I'm going to say boom, 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 and so forth. And so this is t and this is f, my function. And if I want to calculate the average, what I can do is calculate the area of this whole thing and then divide by the total period t. So how do I calculate the area? Well, if I know the distance between these two, and which I do, that's dt, then I can assume this is like a big box. So what I can do is to say a equals 0. And then as I calculate these points, which is what I'm doing, I can say dA is going to be f dt, right? dt f. And then I just add that to that and add up all the a's. And then my average, I'll call it average, would just be a over t. And we should get 1/2. And I haven't done this, so if it messes up really bad, it is my fault. But okay, so we're down here. I'm going to say a equals 0. I'm going to calculate the little bit of area, and in order to find the total, I need to add it to something. So I have to have something to start with. That something's going to be 0. I have to start with a as 0. So there's my f already. I just need to calculate dA. And there is a question, right? Well, if I do, I'm going to have one fewer area than thing, right? Because the data points, I have two data points to make an area. And so I'm actually going to get one extra area. I don't care. Because if my dt is small enough, it doesn't matter. That one extra thing's not going to matter. And we'll check that out. So I'm just going to say f times dt. Now I'm going to add that. A equals a plus dA. And that's it. Now let's do this. Print. F average equals a over t. That's it. And it should be close to 1/2. It might not be exact. Look at that. What do you think? That's pretty cool. So the average is 1/2. If you want to do that another way, you'd have to integrate, do the same thing and integrate, which is letting that It's doing the same thing. It's adding up all those tiny little rectangular areas, but as dt goes to zero. So you have an infinite number of pieces. That's what an integral is. This is a numerical integral. The end.